Hello and welcome to Wade's World, the Deadpool podcast. Fun and mayhem are in store for you, and if you're watching this on Google Hangout, we're all the stages tonight. I am Phil Parrish, and with me, as always, is...
Hey guys, this is Willow, and it's bedtime for me. I'm in my pajamas, and y'all don't need to see that.
Me too. We're talking about Daredevil Deadpool 97. It was kind of the annual that year, and I think
both of them?
Yeah, I think it was this year. I thought they did this in 98, unless they did it for 2 years. But I think there was at least 1 year where Marvel did like a bunch of team up annuals, like because I remember like a Captain America Iron Man one.
Yeah, I was like, oh yeah, I remember when they did this, and this is one of the reasons I take hiatuses from Marvel quite frequently. And any like small slight, I'm like, all right, that's it. I'm done. I think it was around this time they'd done something with a couple of characters. I was like, you know what? I'll be back in 5 years. Now I'm looking through my collections, and I went out and bought this one, but I was like, why do I have Deadpool Suicide Kings, but I don't have Deadpool?
Yeah, exactly.
It's just like, where are my priorities here?
No. And the nice thing about this one, because, you know, a lot of times, most times, annuals don't, like, fit into the ongoing story.
Yeah.
Like, this one was, like, smack dab in the middle of Deadpool's run, of course. That's why we're reviewing it. But I think even, like, the issue after this at Daredevil, it got mentioned, too, so.
But you know what was never mentioned again?
What?
Deuce.
After he got mentioned after this. The way the story ends, he got transferred to Deadpool's book, and then after a while, Weasel leaves with Deuce, and then you never hear from him.
Yeah. It's not too long after that the dog disappears.
Yes.
But you knew something funny was gonna go on when they mentioned the dog in the damn credits of the blurb. Everybody's support favorite supporting character.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. The whole dog thing was goofy. It started off in Daredevil, but yeah, it's just all goofy.
Yeah. I was just like, are they making fun of Ace? Or what's
going on? Ace, Deuce.
Exactly.
But yeah,
what's our top 10 this week then?
Well, funny you should ask, since we're talking about Daredevil, we went with what the top 10 team ups Daredevil's had.
They're like, another Daredevil! We did Daredevil last week, but that's okay, because it makes sense. It's organic, as the kids say on Reddit. So let's just jump into our top 10, and I think you'll notice a definite pattern with my list, probably, as always. Number 10 for me is Black Widow.
Nice.
And it's just like, come on, get Charlie Cox in a movie with Black Widow. She don't belong with Bruce or Tony or Cap. Let Daredevil have her.
And considering the romantic nature of their team up, quote unquote, I'm sure Charlie Cox is like, yeah, team up Scarlett Johansson, yeah.
If only she'd ever do TV. Netflix or nah.
Unless you can sneak him in a movie or something. I'd watch a Daredevil Black Widow live action movie with those two. You know, like an MCU movie.
I say we scrap Inhumans and put it on ABC. Sorry, Charlie.
Charlie's all down on it. He has no faith in Inhumans, which is pretty bad. I mean, Charlie Esther is like Marvel's number one cheerleader. And when he's like, sees the, you know, just the previews, and he's like, oh yeah, this isn't going to be good, then you know you're in trouble.
It was like me when I gave up on episode 2 of Legends. I was like, I'm out. Somebody else has to deal with this crap.
Exactly. All right. I guess number 9 then. I'll say Deadpool, because this story was pretty freaking good. I think this was the actual issue I read where I was just like, oh yeah, I'm in with Deadpool for the long haul. And 20 years later, here I am. I can't believe the story. I remember buying this brand new. I can't believe it's been 20 years.
We're all old. It's okay.
I listen to you.
My number 8 is Luke Cage.
Nice.
Yeah. One of my favorite panels ever having to do with Daredevil is him and Luke Cage eating the burger. I absolutely love that panel.
What issue is that?
I forget. It's one of their first meetings. I think it's like the second time they encounter each other, whatever issue that is.
Oh, but that reminds me. No, we got to get to. There was an issue of around the same time, there was a Heroes for Hire series with, you know, Iron Fist, Luke Cage, a couple other people. And, like, Deadpool was in an issue with that. We should review that one.
Oh, yeah. Let's just get them all in.
I think he gets hired as, like, a freelancer. all right. Number seven, I guess. Spider-Man.
Really? So low?
I mean, it's... I don't know. They're all I
that did feel like a cash grab. I'm not gonna lie, so I can understand why it might not.
Well, I mean, there were some early ones where it was like, "Oh yeah, this is cool," but yeah, once that there that monthly Deadpool Spider-Man Deadpool started, just like a cash grab.
I could see that. Number six, White Tiger. Do you see the pattern yet?
That's all right.
Yeah, I mean, it was random, but I enjoyed it.
That's what she said.
Yeah, literally.
Yeah. All right, and next one on my list. These team-ups are so much fun because most of their team-ups involves them, like, beating on each other. At first, because one of them is being mind controlled or under the influence of something, then they kind of team up. Daredevil and Captain America, because there was issues of Captain America where he was brainwashed, and then Daredevil kind of had to beat some sense into him, and then Streets of Poison late years later when Captain America was like unintentionally under the influence of drugs, Daredevil had to fight him again, and then.
It's so weird. Like, I love Superman, but I just hate Captain America. Like, I don't hate him, but I like movie Captain America. I don't like comic book Captain America. I just don't.
I haven't liked him. I mean, I like him, but, like, when I think of Captain America, I think of the Mark Gruenwald stuff.
Yeah.
And even some Mark Waid after that. I'm just like,
Yeah. They really need to do, like, I get what they're trying to do with that whole situation we have right now, but it still didn't entice me.
Yeah, I think they're kind of going to do, like, a soft reboot on Captain America after this whole Hydra Cap thing.
I hope so I can jump in and try again. Like, even when Falcon's, like, Captain America, I just don't dig the Captain America books. I don't know what they can do, but I'll give it a try if they do a little soft reboot.
All right, next on your list?
Echo.
Nice, yes.
I enjoyed that whole thing because it was like the similar but dissimilar, let's wallow in our misery kind of thing.
Yeah, almost like an updated version of Elektra.
Yep. But cooler because she was, you know, she was born deaf. So.
Yes.
And she was a copycat, so I thought that was pretty cool. I like heroes with that power. It reminds me of the girl from Heroes a lot.
Of course, you liked it there. All right, next on my list, and you'll see a pattern on my list. It seems like most of these encounters are confrontational, especially this one. Especially this one, Daredevil and the Punisher.
Yes! Now that was some good reading, son.
Whenever they encounter each other, you know it's getting bloody.
Yep. Number two for me, I'd be remiss if I didn't. I saw that you didn't put it on the list, so I did. Elektra. It's just kind of like they have to.
Another personal team up.
Yes. They're like, wait a minute, are you saying Luke Cage? No, only in my fanfic. Don't worry about it.
All right, and my last one, number one, just because I'm nostalgic, Daredevil and the Inhumans, or at least Gorgon and Karnak.
Can I get an honorable mention?
Hmm.
I like when he founded Marvel Knights. That was I enjoyed that.
Oh yeah, the Kevin Smith arc.
Of course, such a bad girl. I'm sorry.
That's all right. We should do a special. We should cover those issues. But I mean, we can't do it for Wade's World, but we could do it for Capes and Lunatics. Because I mean, we already covered Kevin Smith stuff for Queen Consolidated. We could do the Marvel side.
Yeah, it's only fair. Equal representation, unless you're an independent. I'm kidding. We'll get to it eventually. I saw some really good stuff coming up in Valiant, some maxi series. So I'll give you a list.
I mean, I'm not picky. I mean, we could do comic books for book club also.
No, I'm kind of a stickler when it comes to book clubs, though.
Okay, then we'll have to do. We'll have to do some kind of comic book club.
So let's get into this jam-packed 46-page double annual issue. It's a lot to unpack.
That's right.
Can I just say that Deadpool reminded me a lot of Bullseye? Like, you remember when he first met Bullseye, it was kind of obvious it wasn't really their first meeting. And that's kind of the vibe I got with this one. It's like, yeah, he's worked with Deadpool before.
That was kind of weird. Yeah, because I just read this not too long ago, and I think he said at least twice, he's like, oh, so Deadpool, we meet again. And like when Deadpool first shows up at the office, he's like, oh, it's Deadpool. And it's just like, well, wait, where does he know him from? Because before he got his own series, Deadpool was kind of, fully ensconced in those mutant books. I don't think he was showing up for the big events like he does, these days.
They know each other from a bar. Or in trouble with the law or something like that. That's the way I took it.
His hypersenses can hear everything.
Unfortunately for him in this case.
Yeah, I know. He even says, oh, why couldn't it be my ears then?
So in retrospect, you're right. That last issue that we talked about was a perfect, quote unquote cliffhanger into this one. And they really did humanize Mary a little bit more in this.
Mm-hmm.
Still don't like her, but they tried. They gave it the good. They gave it the good old college try.
Mm-hmm.
I can appreciate that.
But I just love I love the early Joe Kelly Deadpool stuff. Just the jokes, like when Typhoid gets the drop on Deadpool and he's like, did I have a turn the pants off you yet? And looking at her costume, he's like, oh wait, someone beat me to it.
Yeah. Mad Max reject.
I know, it's with the football pad spikes on his shoulders and stuff.
Always makes me think when I see that, it always makes me think of like the California Love video.
Well, I mean, not that her first costume was any better. I mean,
slightly.
She had the fishnets.
You know, I love a girl with fishnets.
Mm-hmm.
Zatanna, Black Canary.
I mean, she kind of has fishnets here too.
So therapy's not a no go for Mary, is what we've learned from this journey. Just gotta let a crazy girl be a crazy girl, man.
Deadpool tried to do his own form of therapy.
Therapy. McLoving therapy doesn't always work for everybody.
The body count for this therapy was just...
The good old days when a book could be a book. Not worried about offending people. I miss it.
What did you think of the team-up of Foggy and Weasel?
It's everything, and this needs to be like a TV show.
I know. You want to do freaking Powerless? Marvel, do this.
Yeah.
I just love Weasel. He's like, he doesn't make you disarm bombs or something. And Foggy's like, no, we just hang out. He's like, did Daredevil use another friend?
Yeah, they were perfect together. It's the best thing about this book for me.
Mm-hmm. Kind of kept it from getting too dark.
Exactly. And I never really thought that Weasel and Foggy would be a good combination. Like, if you just kind of pitched it to me, I'd be like, I don't know. Oh, Joe Kelly's writing it? Okay, never mind.
Well, it kind of works, too, because I'm trying to remember. I think he was writing both books at this time, too. Well, he was writing Deadpool. I think he was writing Daredevil at this point.
Yeah. Is this? I'd have to look that up.
I'm pretty sure he did at some point, so I'm thinking of this might be.
Two birds, one stone. If that's the case.
I hear the rush people, everyone running to their phones to check.
And then there's just that those two guys that just know. No, actually, I used to be that person, and then I had to start looking, and I can't remember everything.
I can't find the exact date, but yeah, I mean, I've seen issues of Joe Kelly Daredevil when it's around that time, so
I might have to go back and try to complete some of my Daredevil collection. It goes like the 60s to like 89, then it's like 93 to 96, and then it's like 2000 to 2004.
God, I basically have like the complete run from like Born Again to now.
Oh wow!
And if some stuff before it, but yeah, I'm like, that's like when it. Man, now I want to review some Daredevil stuff, but that's okay. We're Deadpool, damn it!
Attention to the guys on capes.
Yeah. Well, that's the problem, just getting everybody the material to review. I mean, I told you, we'll have to do a comic book club, too.
Definitely. So, do you have a favorite panel?
Mm-hmm. Oh, definitely. It's with him, when Deadpool and Weasel are standing there, and they thought they were getting ripped off by the cab driver, so Deadpool blew up his cab with a rocket launcher.
Good one too, but mine's a little more simple. It's the panel where Mary's laying on top of Deadpool and he's having all these thoughts. I was just like, that's about right.
What crazy thoughts.
But then I go, I miss Siren. Get off of him, Mary.
Yeah, but even Daredevil said, which he's been on the receiving end of it before. She has a way of like, you know, she's like a siren, but she pulls men in against their will.
Yeah. She almost had me rooting for it, and I remembered Siren, so I was like, oh, you gotta go, Mary.
But yeah, I mean, just that whole Daredevil and Typhoid thing is dark, because I mean, she like, you know, got him to cheat on Karen Page, and then eventually Daredevil like slept with her, so her guard was down and had her committed. She woke up and she was like committed.
Karen has never been my favorite Marvel love interest, though. So,
I don't know. Like later on, I like their relationship, especially like
she's Abby. Mean, Joe Kelly. She is to Daredevil, no, but Abby no. is the Swamp Thing. I'm sorry.
You take that back.
Never!
I'll never forgive Kevin Smith for killing Karen.
See, that's why I like Kevin Smith.
Oh.
I'm kidding. Mostly. So when do you think they're going to reboot this whole thing? Give it another what? 2 years? They'll be doing another Daredevil.
Oh, what? Origin? Or?
Deadpool annual team up.
It's...
I mean, their numbers are getting low there, so they got to do something.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I was going to say, you think you'd sell more copies? I mean, Deadpool's more popular now than he was then, and, you know, Daredevil's
made a resurgence thanks to the TV show, so.
Yeah, I mean, his name's out there more because of Netflix, yeah.
And we don't have to remember Ben Affleck and Jennifer Garner, like, yeah. We could erase that taste out of everybody's mouth.
Oh, it's coming. Watch, he'll show up in that new Defenders book that's coming.
Definitely has to have a cameo, right?
Yeah, man. Then he could swing by, see his old buddies Daredevil, Luke Cage.
Jessica Jones, he's had a team up with.
I was going to say, he's going to just smart mouth everybody, and Jessica's going to like punch him in the face or something. He's going to be in love.
I need this to happen.
Yes.
It's funny because Daredevil has teamed up with pretty much all of the Defenders individually and as a team. So,
well, over the last couple of years, I mean, who hasn't Deadpool teamed up with? Oh, he had his own team up book for a while.
Yeah, we discussed one of them.
Well,
the Stranger one.
We'll have to get there.
So what would you give this?
I give this an A because, just like I said, I mean, I started collecting Deadpool, but when I hit this issue, because I was reading Daredevil too, but I was just like, I love their interactions. I mean, I thought Deadpool, the funny was hitting on all cylinders. Joe Kelly, good job. But yeah, I remember I enjoyed this when I first picked it up when it was brand new. A for me.
I'm going to give it an A minus because it did smack of a cash grab just a little bit. But it was a great cash grab. It was worth the money, 46 pages, and it was very well written. The art was great. Mm-hmm. And it was bittersweet at the end, just the way we like our Deadpool and our Daredevil.
Yeah, but I think, it was part of the theme because, like I said, a lot of books, all the annuals that year, maybe even the year after, they did the team-up thing. And I mean, this one was executed well, and especially since I think Joe Kelly was writing both Daredevil and Deadpool's books, so it worked out great. The characterization was spot on for the time.
Definitely. That's something that I always get really, like, leery about when team-up books happen. Like, when we were talking about the Lazarus contract, they really did find their footing with that and how to get everybody in character. That's, like, really the key to a good team-up book, is making sure everybody is still themselves.
Oh, yeah. So, anything else? You know what? We haven't done any random nonsense.
I have plenty of random nonsense, sir. I just want to do this as a PSA for the DCEU actors. So I'm scrolling on Facebook, and everybody, like all the Marvel actors, are really happy that Wonder Woman is a hit. Meanwhile, Chris Pine's popping off at the mouth about MCU. And I'm just like, stay classy, Chris. Stay classy. Just saying. Just a thought. We've only had one good movie. Pipe down over there.
Yeah, and he's already dead, so.
Or is he?
Is he just bitter?
I think he's bitter because his name is Chris and he hasn't been invited to be in a Marvel movie. He feels like he's an actor named Chris in Hollywood. He hasn't been in a Marvel movie.
And all those other Chris's are getting multiple movie appearances. He's like, man, I got killed off in the first one.
Yeah, and he's a sidekick, so. Sam.
You're holding her purse, bro.
Or her shield.
Well, yeah.
Well, that's my random nonsense. How about you?
I don't know. I'm just getting sick of websites spoiling comic books the day before they even release to us, the general public.
Says the guy that spammed the whole group chat with the spoiler.
Because I figured everyone saw it or they're about to see it. I'm telling you, I saw it on at least 3 or 4 different websites. And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, it's the Batman news for, I think, tomorrow's... No, I'm not, I won't say what it is, but tomorrow's Batman 24. And by the time everybody's hears this, you know, our episode will be out. Yeah.
I don't know. We live in a world of inconsiderate jerks. I get it.
There's people like Lilith Hellfire get their reviewers' copies early.
You know, I guess that's their job to do stuff like that to generate buzz, which is why they get them. But, like, I don't know that I would necessarily break a big spoiler like that unless they specifically told me when I got the copy that that's why I'm getting the copy. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And obviously it had to be part of the contract because that's kind of like a huge thing. Like, is it a dream or are we doing this for real? You know? I don't know. Like, it has to be another twist to it in order for them to say that specifically. So I'm interested to see it. It definitely generated a lot of buzz. So.
Mm-hmm. Oh, definitely. I'm just wondering.
But yeah, you can't throw it. Like, you just stay off of Twitter. Like, Tuesday nights, just stay off of Twitter, bro. If you are looking forward to a new comic book day, stay off of Twitter.
Yeah, that's true. I follow
Instagram. Don't go on Twitter.
Yeah, I was going to say, because I can't even go on Facebook because CBR and all that I followed. Yeah.
Why? Do you really enjoy their 15 lists?
No.
They've been so decisive and pushy and so negative against DC that I literally had to unfollow them on all social media. Like, I just...
Oh, they just put up articles that get clickbait because, you know, they'll put up an article that says, why did DCEU is better than the MCU? And it's just like, yeah, okay, come on.
And we all know they hate DC. Like, they have far more articles saying how much they hate DC than they do how much they hate Marvel. I'm just saying.
Well, they'll just put up articles that go against, you know, the popular opinion. It's just like, okay. I see what you're doing there.
Well, every site's clickbait, though, now. Even the news has been clickbait for ages. Don't want to die? Watch the news at 10.
There's something in your house that could kill you.
Find out what at 10.
Well, watch out. Watch an hour from now. Yeah.
You know, that's just the nature of society now. So, you know, you can harm it. It's okay.
But anyway, speaking of clickbait, you could follow us at the Wade's World Podcast. Follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/Wade's World Podcast. At Twitter, we're at Wade's World Pod. Instagram, Wade's World, Deadpool Podcast. Pinterest, Wade's World, the Deadpool Podcast. And email us, wadesworldpod@gmail.com. And of course, you can always contact us at the big daddy of them all, capesandlunatics@gmail.com. And send us voicemail, even if you want to do some Deadpool. We'll play it here, 614-382-2737. That's 614-38-CAPES. And Lilith, where can people talk to you about all the spoilers they've seen?
First of all, I want to say Wade's World actually doesn't endorse fake news or clickbait. but you guys can follow me on Twitter at Lilith Hellfire for all DC stuff. And then for everything else, you can follow me at Adventures in FG, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest. Adventures in FG. And be sure to check out my website, adventuresinfangirling.com.
And as for me, if you want to contact me personally, especially if you're a comics creator, maybe on Deadpool, or if you're someone from the Deadpool movie, you can email me, nightwingpdp@gmail.com. And on Twitter, I am at nightwingpdp. And any of those ways we just mentioned, if you want to contact us, send us your suggestions. What should we be covering? What Deadpool stories do you want to hear us cover on the Wade's World Podcast? I was thinking maybe a few more issues of Joe Kelly's run, then maybe do some Gail Simone stuff, and then maybe even jump into Agent X.
Or Cable.
Okay. Well, I didn't know. Well, do you want to do the, at least do, after some more Joe Kelly, do you want to do some of the Gail Simone Deadpool issues, or
yeah,
you
want to
go
fun.
Straight? Yeah.
We can jump around. We got time. We got so many issues.
We've got a lifetime, a career. And then once that animated series hits, you know what we're covering.
Oh, definitely live commentary or something like that. I don't know. Yeah.
Yes, at least covering the whatever episode dropped that week. Yes.
I'm excited.
I know. Please don't blow this. Donald Glover, please don't blow this.
Which just one last bit of random nonsense. I was watching the Homecoming trailer. I'm like, wait, he made it because he really did want to be Miles Morales, and like people were petitioning hard for him. But he made it to at least be in the Spider-Man movie, so that's good for him.
I have no problem with Donald Glover, but isn't he a little old to be Miles Morales?
Not at the time he was petitioning for it.
true. Yeah.
Years in the making here.
That is true. A good Spider-Man movie. Yeah. I can't wait. I hope that's good too.
Yeah. Okay, take us out of here, Phil.
All right, everyone. Please connect with us on the interwebs, and we can have us a Wade's World listener team up 17 instead of 97. All right. I'm loopy. It's late. Rob, hit the music.